Again, Penn Wrestling fans, welcome back to the Penn Wrestling Report, brought to you by the Penn Sports Network. I'm your host, Chaz Dorman. While the Red and Blue were off from actual intercollegiate competition over the weekend, they did spend quite a bit of time in the wrestling room fine-tuning their technique and conditioning, getting set for the six-week grind towards championship season, the IWA Championships, of course, at Bucknell University in early March, followed by the NCAA Championships just down the street at the Wells Fargo Center, March 17th through the 19th. Much-needed respite for the Quakers after a trip down to Virginia where they came away with two wins. A good chance for the veteran Quakers to show the younger guys what it's like to prepare themselves for this final stretch of dual matches. Big dual matches against EIWA teams, Ivy League opponents, and some non-league foes coming in as well. As the team gets ready, tries to set their starting lineup in preparation for championship season about 6 weeks away. One of those Quakers keeping things on an even keel as they head towards the end of the season is 133-pounder Rollie Peterkin, ranked number 4th in the nation, of course, after his 19-1 start to the season, including 16-0 at his prime weight of 133 pounds. This weekend on Sunday, Hofstra is in the Palestra, and for Peterkin, that means a rematch against number 6 Lou Rugarello from Hofstra, a rematch from the Southern Scuffle where Peterkin picked up a 6-0 win and the championships at 133 pounds, throwing in a very nice backflip to get himself out of a precarious position in the first period, tossing in a 5-point throw towards the end of the match in the third period to secure that big victory over Rugarello. Peterkin, a veteran of the battles, EIWA champion in 2008 and a finalist in 2009, knows that it's all about keeping your momentum and your mind ready as you head towards the end of the season. Rollie, the team's had, you know, about 2 weeks off since its last dual meets against Virginia and VMI. A two-week break like that in the middle of the season is very rare for a wrestling team. What have you guys been working on in the room to hone your technique as you head into the final 6 weeks of the season?
It's very important that we take advantage of the time off and use it as an opportunity to learn new technique and work on our conditioning. When you don't have to wrestle during like last weekend, you can focus on other things besides, you know, tapering for a match or losing your weight. So we really spent a lot of time in the room focusing on very specific technique and positions that we've been working on, some of the problems that the coaches noticed from the Virginia match. And we also did a lot of conditioning, and I think we're in pretty good shape going into the rest of the season.
Is that something that could benefit a team, giving you a chance to recharge your batteries while also focusing on some of the, you know, the nuts and bolts of a wrestling match there as you head into what's going to be a very difficult and strenuous and obviously important 6 weeks here as we head towards March?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, this is the so-called grind coming up, and I think that you definitely have to take advantage of the time off that we had, and if you use it properly, it can definitely be a big advantage for you. And I know the coaches gave us a few days off there. You know, they believe in measured rest and working hard at the same time, or back to back, you know, working hard, measured rest. And I think it's very important for our training cycle at this point.
As one of the leaders on the team, one of the seniors, what do you do to some of the younger guys in the room, and, you know, to help, you know, stress upon them the importance of taking care of your body at this point of the season, of knowing when to push and when to pull back, and how to get yourself into that rhythm, as, you know, some of these guys are going to be going, you know, longer and against more difficult competition than they've seen in their career so far.
Well, it's pretty rare this year that we actually have, you know, a bunch of freshmen in the lineup. How many do we have starting? Like four, I think, three or four right now. And that's the best experience for them, you know, just making it through an entire college season, because a lot of times you don't know what it's really like until you actually are there, and there's problems you have to deal with on a daily basis, making sure you feel good every day and making sure you're ready for competition, keeping your weight down, getting your schoolwork done. And I think they're doing an excellent job, and, you know, I try to stress those kind of important things every day, and, you know, hopefully it pays off for them.
As we look ahead to this weekend for the Quakers, Saturday afternoon, Bucknell comes to the Palestra. On Sunday afternoon, the Hofstra Pride are here in the Palestra, taking on the Red and Blue. And for you, Rollie, you know, you're ranked number 4 in the country at 133 pounds. You know, you're putting yourself in a great position for a high seed, you know, obviously at EIWAs and again at Nationals, making a run for a national championship. Somebody, you know, your toughest competition to date came at the Southern Scuffle in the finals against Lou Rugarello, who's ranked around number 6 in the country from Hofstra. You guys are looking at a rematch this Sunday here at 133 pounds. What are you going to take from that match that you guys had on, you know, on the platform under the lights in Greensboro? A very exciting 6-0 win for my buddy here on my left. And, you know, put in your mind what you're going to need to do to defeat him again on Sunday.
I think it was a little different going into that first match. I was kind of the underdog in terms of the rankings, at least, not in my mind. But I think that I wrestled my best match that time, and I just have to go out there and, you know, learn from what I did last time and maybe change a few things up, and definitely go out there expecting to win. And, you know, the pressure's on him this time. He's got to perform, and, you know, I definitely think I can beat him one more time, and that'll seal it for nationals and seal my ranking and my seed for nationals.
For the team here, these two duels this weekend, Bucknell and EIWA rival, you know, two Pennsylvania schools, always a lot of history and whatnot going on between PA schools. And then, you know, Hofstra team, it's always on the schedule for the Quakers. You know, going back a little bit to what we talked about, a lot of guys on the team here, the dual meets we've had so far this season are against good teams, but nobody that really is a historical rival for the Quakers. And now here we are looking at two teams that, you know, the alumni and fans of wrestling know that Penn Bucknell and Penn Hofstra sometimes mean something. And, you know, how do you try to get those guys up and ready to go this weekend?
I definitely think, like you said, they are historic matches. Bucknell, you know, they recently brought the program back, but they're full force. They're a good team. Definitely can't underestimate them. And I think that everyone on the team knows that. And they're solid top to bottom. So we're going to have to come out there to wrestle. And I think we did against Virginia and VMI, and we have some good momentum going. And Hofstra, you know, we've dueled them, I think, every year since I've been there. And both teams hosting them in the Palestra here is special. And I think that we'll be able to step it up for these big home matches.
All right, well, best of luck this weekend. And
thank you.
Good luck, and we'll see you next week.
Thank you, Chaz.
One man who will definitely be counting on Peterkin's veteran leadership to guide the way through five important home matches over the next 2 weeks will be head coach of the Quakers, Rob Eiter. Had a chance earlier this week to sit down with Coach Eiter, talk about what him and his coaching staff were working on over the break with the Quakers, and his thoughts on the two duels coming in this week with Bucknell and Hofstra coming to the Palestra on Saturday and Sunday. Coach, last time we talked, you were getting ready to begin about 13-day span of days off for the guys, you know, from actual matches. But, you know, getting into the room and getting back to basics and on technique and conditioning. Mm-hmm. How's that break from live, you know, intercollegiate action been for the team as they get ready for the final six-week grind towards championship season?
Well, it was good. I mean, we got some good workouts in, and also used it as a recovery for, you know, some nicks and bruises that we have right now. So, you know, moving forward, we're not going to have a lot of time to take that time. So. Mm-hmm. I think it was, you know, pretty good that we got that extra week in and let some guys heal up a little bit and get ready for that last push.
We talked with Rollie Peterkin a little bit earlier this week about, you know, the team, you know, him being a senior leader and trying to help some of the freshmen, you know, understand that, okay, we've kind of reached a turning point here. There's about 6 weeks to go, and it's, you got to go all out here, a little bit different from what they might be used to in a high school season. Have you been kind of doing the same thing, you guys as a coaching staff, to help with some of those? You do have four freshmen starting in the lineup right now, to let them know that, you know, you may think tournaments are tough, but we got, you know, 6 weeks of intensive dual meets here before we even get to EIWAs.
We have a little bit, you know, but, you know, for the most part, we're just, you know, getting them ready for the next competition. Mm-hmm. And don't want to overwhelm them,
sure.
So to speak. So just, you know, again, one match at a time. And you know, obviously, you know, pointing out that each match is very important and means that much more, you know, at the end of the year here. So
For the team, you know, the next match coming up is that there's two duels this weekend, Bucknell on Saturday here in the Palestra, and Sunday you come right back at it against Hofstra inside the Palestra. And, you know, for those are two we talked about with Rollie, you know, Bucknell and Penn, EIWA foes, you know, Pennsylvania schools here, there's always something going on there with two PA schools. And Hofstra and Penn were always on the schedule. And, you know, those are tough matches, and, you know, there's a little bit of history there as well with those two teams. So, you know, what's, you know, coming inside here in the Palestra, two big home duels for you guys. Is there a little bit of excitement about having some, you know, some intensity of these duels as opposed to some of the early season ones that were against teams you were wrestling for the first time?
Sure. Well, both matches are real important. Obviously, Bucknell for conference, you know, seeding and just it's always good to wrestle teams in your conference. And they have, you know, some good individuals, so it's going to be important for some individuals on our team to get that spot. And then Hofstra as well, you know, from a national standpoint, they have probably four or five guys nationally ranked, and just so happens about the same match up perfectly with our four or five guys that are ranked. So, again, you know, there's going to be a couple of rematches there. Right now, I think we're two out of three with them. We beat their 25 and 33, lost their 84 already in previous competitions. So we're looking to keep the two and then flip the third one there. But, you know, Coach Shiflett's done a great job in keeping that program moving in the right direction. And, you know, it's always good to wrestle a good, tough team like that. So.
Mentioned seedings for both the IWAs and for NCAAs. Right after you walked out of the studio last week on my my handy BlackBerry there, I got emailed the first NCAA coaches panel rankings. Very important, obviously, when it comes to conference, you know, berths for NCAAs and for Penn. And, you know, Penn had six wrestlers in the top 33 across the different weight classes, including three top 10s, and Rollie Peterkin at 133 pounds, Zach Kemmerer at 141 pounds, and Micah Burak at 197 pounds. Is that about where you expected, you know, this team to be right now, and where do you see room for improvement, not only in the six that are already inside the rankings, but those four weight classes where the red and blue are looking to move into?
Yeah, I mean, you know, we're real pleased with that. Of course, you know, there's some others that we felt should have been a little higher, and we're hoping to get higher. You know, Scott Giffen being one, you know, been out of competition for a while, and, you know, he's due back in a couple weeks. So, you know, he'll definitely boost the rankings and the team and things like that. So, you know, again, Kyle Cowan, I think, should be right up there with his last week's performance. Again, consistency, he just needs to stay a little bit more consistent to get the notice of the coaches that he can be consistent and continue to win and beat some of the top guys. So, you know, we're pretty happy where we're at. You know, obviously we want to continue to move up that ladder. So until you have all 10 ranked, your job's not done.
Sure. Well, the opportunity for improvement and the consistency that Coach Eiter and every coach is always looking for comes back into play on Saturday afternoon at the Palestra. And Coach, we'll check in with you next week after hopefully two Penn wins here inside the Palestra.
Okay. Very good.
We'll be sure to get back with Coach Eiter next week, checking in on how the Quakers do against the Bison and the Pride over the weekend. For those of you checking out the schedule here for the Quakers, Bucknell comes inside the Palestra on Saturday afternoon at 3 p.m. 1 o'clock p.m. on Sunday is the start time for the duel with Hofstra. If you can't be there inside the Palestra, as always, both matches will be broadcast live online at PennAthletics.com for you faithful subscribers to the Penn Sports Network. For more information on Penn Wrestling, all things Penn Athletics, be sure to check the home of the Penn Sports Network, PennAthletics.com.